I've always been into kind of the different animals. So reptiles, sharks when I was little. I got a gecko when I was 10 as my first pet. I always liked those different animals. And then when I was an eighth grader going into high school, I went out with a turtle researcher into the field, and I was like, oh my gosh, this is great. I love being out in the field. I love finding stuff in the field and learning more and how to help these animals in the wild. And then I got an internship here at the zoo when I was doing my studies at Colorado State. And I was like, well, I want to work at a zoo now. My name is Max Maloney. I'm our lead keeper here in Tropical Discovery at Denver Zoo. As a lead keeper, I do lots of animal care still, but I interact with our supervisors a lot more and pass information back and forth between those two levels. So we are currently in our, what we call our mezzanine of the Tropical Discovery building. So our building is basically a greenhouse while it is also a display for animals. As it pertains to our building and our animals in particular, having the ability to have live plants grown here and then to put them in displays makes our displays that much better. It gives our animals the opportunity to actually use real foliage, and that means a lot, particularly for our amphibians. Our amphibians like to lay eggs and nest inside of like live bromeliads, and that is something you can't really recreate with a plastic plant. And then as far as the broader zoo, our horticulture team grows a lot of plants here that we call browse. And browse is used, it's plants that get used to feed other animals. So a lot of browse is for our primates, our pachyderms, so rhinos and elephants, and even our capybaras down below us also get that browse. So really, the plants that are grown here aren't just for this building, it's for the whole zoo. So in this building, we have over 300 different species. Now, a lot of that comes from our fish, right? So our fish tanks are absolutely busting with different species. Every tank is a multi-species exhibit. Within our fish hallway, we have a multitude of different, you know, body styles of fish, from eels to puffer fish to angel fish. We have some scorpion fish that look like coral. I mean, we have a lot of really cool stuff. Obviously, the sloths are a big draw. People love sloths, and we, as a team, honestly are a little new to the sloths, and we're very pleased that we now have a full sloth family, mom, dad, and baby. That new display for the sloths is something to always come and check out. And then you get into some of our reptiles and amphibians. Those are also multi-species, a little less so than the fish. For me, one that I really want to highlight off the bat that came to mind straight away is our Orinoco crocodile. So we have two Orinoco crocodiles. One of them is on display, one of them is in back, just because they are big enough we need to keep them separate. These guys I want to highlight in particular because it's such a unique opportunity for zoos in general. It's a project that's across AZA facilities led by Dallas World Aquarium. These guys were hatched in captivity and they're actually going to be released into the wild. And then of course Komodo dragons. I mean, Komodos are super, super cool. One of my favorite things about the Komodo dragons are just kind of their actual docile nature and intelligence they display in captivity. We are in the process of getting another male and continuing that breeding project here. So, I mean, Komodos kind of rule one whole side of the building, so they're always a good one to see. Just this building alone has more animals than the rest of the zoo. Now, a lot of that comes from our bats and our fish, but still, like as I said, we have 100 plus displays, and that is a lot of species and a lot of different just individual animals that we house here. Another thing with this building is it is so diverse in its collection. So most of us in this building, as you might guess, are reptile, amphibian, and fish people. But as we've highlighted already, we have mammals. We have sloths, we have capybara, we have bats. So just that breadth of diversity, you have to be very flexible in your knowledge set, your skill set, and how to set all these animals up for success and so that they can thrive and be living enriched full lives here at the zoo. The biggest seller for Tropical Discovery is just the amount of animals you're gonna see in here. We have so many different kinds of animals, so many different species, and just sheer number. It's also a controlled environment, so if it's hot out, it's nice in here. If it's cold out, it's nice in here. I'm wearing shorts year-round. It's a beautiful place to be. I just love our building so much. It has so much to offer. Anytime you're here, you're going to see something new.
Stay elevated by subscribing to the city's YouTube page for these stories and more. And stay tuned to our social media channels for more content. Don't miss our new episodes of Elevating Denver, premiering each month. Thanks for watching, Denver.